mass extinction or destruction. So muna siya mga additional nga mga lungag sa IHL. So unsay violation sa IHL nga mga international standards mao pud diri sa kuha. If it is committed domestically, no, you can file a case against the person perpetrating that, because again, we already have a local IHL counterpart law. Okay, pamunta na lang. And I'll be glad to answer. Go now, go! Or delete lang. Huwag na na! Pahimusli ko ninyo. Walang ako nilang taon-taon. Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
Signatory ba ang NTA sa IHL?
You don't have to be signatory. No? Why? Because ako yung magkas Pilipinas. Ang Pilipinas is a signatory. But we do not require everyone to be a signatory. Because you're deeply part of the Philippines. Di ba? So again, and when you commit a violation of the IHL domestically, dili man ang katong international tong i-apply. Again, ang gingon, 2009, you already have the 8591 or the 8951 is a domestic law passed by Congress mirroring the IHL as an international law. So, di na kinahanglan. Okay? It's a very good question. It's a very good question because, no, inanabihan sa iyong dipinsa. No, hindi na mamimembro anak. Like what our former president, no, is trying to say. No jurisdiction over me. Yun naman. Ninuwa naman ta, nilawag naman ta sa tuwang treaties recognizing the IHL. Okay. Sige.
So this question is from our Google form, no?
Wala.
So the question is, what is the sense of establishing international law if in reality it has no teeth?
If it has no?
If it has no teeth.
Isa may nangutanaan na eh, walay face. walay teeth na pangutanaan, nangutanaan, walay face. But let's distinguish, no? Between the substance of the law and its implementation. It's always the question. Dagang kita gilod ka balaw po din implement. But we also have a principle of non-waiver. What is non-waiver? Just because ang usa ka balaw or wala gi-implement, it does not mean that it can never be implemented. And it applies kita bitaw na, ah, okay raman ni siya, okay. Huwag ito dakpasikuan, okay raman siguro ni. Huwag sadali dakpon ka. May kung huwag ito dakpasikuan, katong naging mga aning butangan eh. Uy, non-waiver. Just because that principle of law was not applied, it doesn't mean that its application has been waived. No? Going back to the question, it's very true. Usahay, dilid yun kayo ma-implementar, but it is still a good law nonetheless. Pwede na ito ng sampulan. No? Pwede sampulan. You see, because it will, sometimes naman it will intertwine, no? Makasuhan na daan of murder, no? Makasuhan na daan of other violation, no? There's double jeopardy, no? Legal na kaya ko istorya. But anyway, in principle, di magkapwede kasuhan for one act, naghan kaayong sa katutang kaso, no? Because the principle of double jeopardy will already set in. Except on some instances. Karang some instances, ato na lang isputan. No? Kung ato ang ini-enroll yung klasihan niyo. Again, it's not easy by to understand. I am very careful, no, na ato ang magkonsepto ka ng ato asang masabtan. Pero, natusin na di mo kasabot, ha? But, again, ato ang pa rin yung mga relevant kayo. No? So, sometimes man lagi, ang ma-file yung case, hindi mag-good violation by HL, kundi naman kidnapping, kundi naman murder, masunod naman na siya dito, no? So, but we want to have test cases, no? Of IHL. I know there has been cases. I know.
Another question po is from Miss Awaj. The question is, if atomic bombs violate IHL, why do some countries still possess such weapons today?
Okay. I think it's part of the treaties, no? Dugay naman kayo, no? Of course, it was only once gigamit. At the time, wala pa international treaties. After that, there was, during Cold War, there was an arms race. The world was divided between two, US and Russia. So, tulog ka po, kinds of nasod, katong aliado sa Amerika, aliado sa Russia, and the third one, which is the makatubag ka nila, bonus. UN? Isa man? Ha? Isa sa? No, Soviet Union, lagi rin na sila. Nung kontra sila sa Amerika, tulo. Ang nations of the world were either aliado, which the Philippines is and was, or Russia, which before Soviet Russia, aliado niya ng mga Romania, mga Hungary before, but there was a third position taken by Switzerland, India, and some other nations, and you call them? Kung saan sila? Third world? Kadatuan nila? They are the non-aligned nations. Non-aligned nations, no? So, katong pag-drop sa bank, pag-drop sa bank, wala pa ta ato yung mga IHL. But later, ipangapila ng mga weapons of mass destruction, and they were treaties, no? Galing doon ay mga agreements, no? Nga i-de-escalate ang paghimo sa nuclear bombs. But of course, some nations are still building it, no? US is still building it. Russia is still building it. Walang man gibawal ang paghimo. It is just the use. And there is an agreement to de-escalate the manufacture. But of course, Pyongyang is making it. India is making it. Pakistan is making it. China is making it. No? In secret. No, muna nga, you know, international relations, mag-existing with it, is an art of balancing everyone's interests just so that we can have peace. No? So, there is really a danger nga we will lapse into this kind of war, Russia and Ukraine. Why? An exception in IHL is that when you use it as a self-defense, so nagulang na kita na ay usaan na musugod. Kung sukta na galing na, there is no stopping. A third world war, and that war would be a war of mass destruction. No? Usa lang ka nuclear bomb? Wala na. Pwede naman ka under IHL, if it is by self-defense, exception man siya. Okay? And that's very true. No? But, nahinay yun ang iyahang pag-progress because of this agreement to de-escalate. Mga bilateral treaties, no, between nations nga, okay, mag-de-escalate so that ang ato ang gera na ginadokang may tabo, hindi may tabo. But you know, it's very, we are living in very dangerous times, really, because of this ongoing war. It has become a proxy war between US again and Russia. Okay. Mga ilang minutes pa? How many time do we have? Two questions more, ma'am? Sige. Three more questions, yes. Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, everyone.
Sorry, sir. Huh? Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, thank you for the wonderful discussion, sir. Although a very short time, sir. My question is that I thank you for your patience. Kay late magugugulo, sir. Wala akong nakasulod sa atong first discussion. But my question is, what does humanitarian law provide in terms of material assistance to the victims of armed conflict?
Okay, so it's a law that governs conduct. It does not, as far as this law is concerned, wala siya nag-obliga o hatag o assistance. Because that's for another, lahit na po na siya, nga jurisdiction, lahit na po na to ang mga organisasyon na doon ay responsibilidad niya na. So, IHL governs the conduct of war. It limits the target of war, the weapons to be used. So, wala na sa clause niya o sa assistance. No? So lahi na po na siya, mga NGO, humanitarian organizations na po ang doon ay saklawan na. And really, no, for purposes of discussion, I don't think there can ever be a law which will obligate you to provide this one. Why? Because laws cannot dictate a specific person. Dili ta pwede maghimog balaod nga ordinansa ng mga taga-UN, kinahanglan inyo ning buhaton ug mao ni mahitabo. because it should apply to everyone. No? Sa nga mga bolsa students, mao gini kurso kuhaon after this subject. Okay? Because laws must apply to all circumstances, to all similarly situated. Okay? So, kanang mga humanitarian organizations, they exist not because of a law, but because of their own constitution and bylaws. In fact, they are independent, usually, by their home state. No? Red Cross is independent of the Philippine government. UN is independent of any other state. So, ingon niya na. Pero na po yung mga kalingguan, national-based rescue, but it is not really, it's part of the government. Kalingguan ito mga NDRRMC, CDRRMC, or MDRRMC. No? Pero again, their mandate does not emanate from international humanitarian law. Nanaylaing balaod na create nila. Two more questions? Ina? Ma'am, sir, timan itong mga simpang tana, high class points. Sige, natin mo rin ako. Nagan pa kayo natulang ng opisina. Sige, two more questions. Very good question. Denial of refugee, is it part of the concept of IHL? Una, is it part of the concept of limiting the effects of war? Does it, is it an action related to the limitation of weapons? Dealing sa, but it may be a violation of all other international conventions. I think in the Geneva Convention, it is a violation. We have the duty to receive refugees. But you know what states are doing? Di ba na lang ngayon kailangan kibalibaran? Ngayon na mas kailangan kiregulate. No? So in answer to the question, it is not a violation of IHL, but it may be, I say may, because depending on the circumstances, it may be a violation of other international agreements, chief of which may be the first Geneva Convention. Okay? One more question. Your excuse. Is it a follow-up question? Okay.
Sir, related po ba dito yung use ang delo or use ang delo sa Geneva Convention? Or
Kung saan ka na lang sa delo?
I really don't know, sir. Medyo na-curious lang ko lang.
Okay. Those are actually when mga Latinisms magunan sila, no? So, okay, i-google na kung saan na siya for the understanding of everyone. Okay, i-google. I'd like to help you. Bellum is war, no? So, it is something from an application. Does it only apply in war? It applies in armed conflict, no? So, yes. Yes. So, it is applicable, that concept is, kung saan mo siya ma-involve, is it just in time of war? The context pa, or bisag wala gira yung nagalit lang. Okay? It applies in times of armed conflict. You know war, there is a dateline. When the war was initiated, when the war ended. But if it is domestic, it's an ongoing war. Waman talaga yun nga, di ba? Longest running insurgency in Asia, gani ang ato ang MPA. So it's an ongoing war. Okay? So to answer the question, it is committed in times of conflict. Yes?
Based on my knowledge, use at Belmont, use at Bello are the principles of war. So, apin dito ang number of scope sa war na na-invalise ka tong we cannot conduct war without magsabot no, from both parties kung unsay mga i-conduct. And then, dito pag inaset ang boundaries parehas at to genocide, I think that's a use at Bello.
Okay, let us not be so much enamored with Latinisms. But anyway, those two concepts has again something to do with when to invoke this law, no? Because bellum is conflict, is Latin, no? For conflict. Gamay ng correction, madam. Dili man kita maglingkod ta, magira ta mo ni atong buhaton. It is not the IHL, mo na gini sa ato ang kita ay embodied, no? When you go to war, mao na ni say ato ang sundon, no? But that is very correct. Again, because the idea is IHL governs the conduct a war to mitigate the damage to those who are not involved in the war. Because really, war, ang atong objective is really just to get what? Territory. Tara naman, territory. Not even the people. Because ang mga tao na nadiya, nakuha nyo lang territory, di man nyo mas lang pwede uyogon o taman o bigyo sila ganahan nyo. No? So, territory. What is necessary to get the territory? Kaya lang. Of course, it's necessary to kill. Yung mga kasunod niya, o dagang pagkaid yung mga combatants. So, pamatir nyo na ito na. Gira mo na eh. But, kanan akong force which is necessary. Necessary force. And, you must also distinguish. Okay? Yes. One more question.
Sir!
Yes, sir.
Sir, mayroong nga po, sir.
Mayroong po, sir.
So, sa mga punishment sa isa ka, kunwari, sa country ang nakalampas sa IHL, sir, unsay mga punishment na sa country, kinsa po nga mga country ang mo, pwede mo reklamo na sila?
Kanan? Kanan, no? As to punishment, dili ako, kanan, dili ba ako familiar kayo. Even sa local laws, dili na to, walay abogado sa iyong familiar sa tanang penalties because of the book of penalties, no? But safe to say, I think the supreme punishment, no, of kisa mo to yung last time nagigikuha na, I think it's in Europe. Kato genocide in Bosnia and Herzegovina, no? He was in prison because ICJ can enforce his judgment. I do not know. I'm very sorry, no? Kung appeal ba ang death penalty, I don't think so. Because, you know, the community of nations abhor the implementation of death penalty. But it is a supreme perpetual punishment. Capital punishment, which is perpetual punishment. I forgot the name, basta the last conviction was the guy, perpetrator of the genocide in Bosnia and Herzegovina in the 1990s. But can it possibly naghani karon kung mga war crimes? Okay, wala na yung question?
In support lang sa iyo, kang lingon for advice na mga kanang. With regards to punishments, we have mga good public international law and private international law. So when countries are involved in cases, I think ang pinaka-main point sa punishment is the repercussions na mga imuhang identity as a country is tainted. Say for example, oil exporting companies na mo-violate sa international law, tapos, magka-conflict na siya para sa oil price hike last year because of war. So, that's the repercussion na if international is violated because of the war matay, sir, no? So, I think, hindi naman pwede presumo ng countries, but then, when we take the diplomatic ties that we have with other neighboring countries, one of the biggest punishment.
Let me correct. There is an individual defendant in a war crime. You do not file a case against the country. You file a case against the president and all those who empowered, no, the commission, abetted the commission of the crime. Prisuhon yun. There is jurisdiction. Pwede niyo prisuhon. Ano siya, no? Kanagin ko ni madam nga repercussion. It's true, but let us differentiate ha. Alalahin ako ni Mestoria. Kung hindi magkot siya criminal case, yung i-file, hindi siya ICC. It is ICJ. No, it's a National Court of Justice. Kaya kung hindi mo sa magpwersa o pamayad, if there is a ruling to pay, diha ka pwede kabad siya. Diha yung reputation at stake. But when you are talking about war crime, you do not file a case against the country. You file a case against the commanders. You file a case against the president. Those who are responsible for the commission of the crime. I have to bid you goodbye. I know our next speaker is already there. And this has been a very fruitful afternoon for all of us. Maraming salamat din po, everybody.